I'm going to talk about the anatomical research for academic resources. The first objective of Web 3.0 is giving meaning to the internet information. And so adding metadata and also the, putting inferences between that metadata helps to search pertinent information, useful information. In this work, we have developed a plugin to provide the content manager of with semantic search capabilities, and through by using inferences. That the application that we are using that does not include. The plugin is applied to a repository with contents created. This is important. Is created by students and not only by teachers. It's also by students in the context of university subject. This is an example of the repository, and you see that here we can define with this plugin we can define different anatomology. In this case, for teamwork and resources, for example, we choose here the degree of biotechnology and also resources with feedback, positive and negative. For example, we can choose. And also related with the stage of teamwork process, related with results, for example. Well, this is a plugin to of WordPress, and WordPress is an application that does not allow inferences. So in this case, using the inferences, we obtain this different results, doing all the combinations between the tags, the different tags. In this, it was applied in the second semester of this year, of the last year, subject in the subject of computer science and programming, and we had three groups. The first two groups didn't know nothing about the repository before using, and the third one had a previous explanation about the repository before using it. I also, in the first group, the students generated the resources and included these resources in the repository in order to use it to use them in the same subject. The percentage of participation was very high, and we are focusing in the attention in one question with four possibilities, the specific conclusion of that the survey and with respect to the questions was that the different the best results of the for the groups in relation with the different resources in the repository if they can obtain all or have an idea, general idea of all the different resources in the repository, and the best results were obtained for the first and the third group. In the first case, I said that they created the resource, and of course they knew what resources they were included. And in the third case, they received a previous explanation about the repository. So it says normal that these are the best results. And for the second option, about if it's quick to recover the information from the repository, the results were good for both cases, and the first and second. And in the third case, were slightly better, but no, with the big differences. In the case of about the navigation about on the repository, it was good research, and the research about the best option was for the third, is because they were the third group had a previous explanation of about the repository, and then it was easier for them to navigate in the repository. And in the last question, if they recommend would recommend the repository to other, to use in other subjects. All the groups said that, okay. And the first, and the best results obtained also for the third group. And so the conclusion said that, well, to know, in order to know the different types of contents included in the repository and using an ontology, it's necessary to participate in the creation, yes, of course. If you are creating the contents, of course you know how to use it. And previous to have or to obtain a previous explanation before starting the repository or using the repository. And the effectiveness of the research through the inferences is shown as the fast search of the useful contents. And the students must receive training before using a repository in order to obtain the best results and the best use of this kind of engine. Because they don't receive this information neither in the classroom nor in the web 2.0. So thank you very much.